Hi, thank you for purchasing our COMA trading system. You can download our COMA trading files from your mail. Here you can see, this is a zip file. Download them and save somewhere. After saving, you can see a zip file like this. If you want to unzip this file, you need to have WinRAR software installed in your computer. If not installed, go to Google and type WinRAR. Free download. You can see here, open this website. Here you can download WinRAR. If your computer configuration is 64 bit, you can download this. Otherwise, you can download this. This one is compatible for 32 bit and 64 bit also. After downloading this software, simply install this. Once you install this software, you can unzip this file. To unzip this file, right click on this file and click extract here. Now you can see COMA trading files folder. Double click on this. You can see indicators and templates folders and instruction manual also. Double click on this indicators folder. You can see two indicators. One is single chart indicator and one is multi-pair multi-time frame dashboard. Copy these two. Now you go to your terminal, click on this file button, open data folder. Here click on MQL4, double click on indicators folder, and now paste those indicators here. So those two indicators have been placed here. Now go back two times again. Now you can see templates folder here. Double click on this and go to the folder where you have downloaded COMA trading files. Go back. Now you can see templates here. Copy these templates and again go to this terminal's template folder and paste. Now these templates have been placed in this terminal. You can close and restart this terminal. Otherwise, simply in navigator panel, in indicators, right click and refresh. Now you can see those indicators have been placed here. If you don't know how to do this, simply close the terminal and restart it once again. That's it. Now indicators and templates have been installed in your terminal. Now if you want to install these indicators directly, you can drag this indicator and put it here. Otherwise, simply go to this templates button to load dashboard, multi-pair multi-time frame dashboard. Click on this. Automatically with already given inputs, this dashboard will be loaded. This is our multi-pair multi-time frame dashboard. This way you can use up to 15 charts and all 9 time frames also can be used. Now if you see a buy opportunity, you will see green color, and if you have sell opportunity, you will see red color. If you want, you can change these dashboard settings also, because M1 time frame, M5 time frame may not be needed. In fact, I don't use all these four time frames also, M1, M5, M15, M30. I use from H1 only. But if you want more trades, you can use them, but only scalpers will use M1 and M5. So we don't want these too importantly. And as this COMA trading system is a trend following strategy, it works perfectly with the trending pairs. Euro USD, GBP USD, Euro JPY, GBP JPY. In AUD USD, New Zealand USD, USD CAD, it may not work perfectly. So if you want to change, right click on this chart, click on indicators list. This is the indicator. Double click, go to inputs. Now you can change some settings. If you don't want some currency pairs, you can delete them. To separate each pair, comma is needed. Okay, so now if you don't want AUD USD, double click, go to the starting point. Now you can delete AUD USD, and if you don't want USD CAD also, you can delete. The same way, if you want to add, you can add also. give a comma and then input the currency pair name in capital letters. But remember, with some brokers, they may use their chart names differently. For example, EURUSD.U or EURUSD.M, some brokers use their names like this. Then you have to change all of them. Change means you have to add that suffix accordingly. Just like how the chart name is here, EURUSD, the same way you have to give the name here. Otherwise, it will not read the data from that chart. So sometimes if your broker is using some different names, EURUSD.U, then you have to put it here as EURUSD.U, comma GBPUSD.U. If your broker uses EURUSDX.X, otherwise some brokers use without dot also, EURUSDX, then you have to use EURUSDX. Same way, how you can see the chart here, you have to give the input here. Then only this indicator can read the data from that chart. The same way, in this time frames list also, if you don't want some time frame, double click and delete them. I don't want M1 and M5, so simply deleted. And monthly time frame also not necessary, so we can remove this one also. Other things, you don't need to change. If you want to change these colors also, you can change. Say for example, this is green. If I want to put it lime, I will put it like this. Now you can see some time frames and some charts have been disappeared. So this way, at any point of time, you can change those settings. And if you want to save this template like this only, then again go to templates, save template, and you can save in this name itself. So double click on this and click yes. Now this template has been saved with these settings. Whenever if you want to change them, once again you can go to this indicators list and double click, and you can change these inputs. Okay, this is all about dashboard. This way you will get buy or sell opportunities on charts. Say for example, right now we have red color in GBPUSD H1, so we have a sell opportunity in this chart. Now if you go to GBPUSD, now we want to install single chart indicator. Go to templates and click comma trading indicator. It takes some time to read the data from your chart. Now we have the opportunity here in dashboard, but we can't see this here. Why? I will show you. Here you can see some arrow. In this indicator also, you can change some settings. To change those settings, right click, click on this indicators list. You can see this indicator here. Here we can change some settings. This is regarding stop loss. We have some options here, but whereas you don't need to use all those things, you can simply use swing highs and lows. This is stop loss and take profit ratio, risk reward ratio. If you want, you can change it. 1:1, right now it is there. If you want to change, you can change it to 1:1.2 or 1:1.5. But 1:1 is suggested, so you can simply put it like this. And this is buffer pips. It will add some pips to support and resistance. And this is minimum stop loss and this is maximum stop loss. You can change this maximum stop loss. Based on the time frame, you have to change these inputs. Right now, I have changed these inputs to maximum stop loss as 100. And you don't need to change these settings also. This one has given as multiple signals. We put it as false actually, because if you put it as true, you will get more signals. When we put it as false, after closing of one buy trade, then only it will take another buy trade. The same way for sell also. But while one buy trade is already open, another sell trade may be taken. But don't take while one open trade is there, buy trade is open, don't take another buy. The same way when already one sell trade is there, don't take another sell trade. Because of that reason only we put it as false. Okay, Now you can see, because previously we put maximum stop loss as 50, so that is why we didn't get these signals. Now we have these signals. You can see this one is a profitable trade, this one is a loss trade, and this one is a profitable trade. Today itself we got the sell signal and it is closed with profit. So this way you can change those settings, and I will show you how multiple signals true or false also. Right click, go to indicators list, again double click. If you put multiple signals as true, now you can see some more signals are there. While this sell trade is still open, here is the take profit. Before reaching this take profit, you got another sell opportunity. And for that, this is the target. The same way, here we get one buy opportunity. Before closing it with stop loss or target, another opportunity has come. Here, advantages and disadvantages, both are there. Here, those two trades closed with profits. Here, those two trades closed with loss. So that is why only while one sell trade is open, only one sell trade. We don't need to take this. While one open buy trade is there, only one buy. We don't need to take this. So that is why we have an option. So if you don't want to get multiple signals, put it as false. Now those signals have been disappeared. So this way we have to use these indicators. Trade with strict money management principles, because this strategy gives you up to 70% winning trades. So some losing trades also will be there, just like this. Overall, you will get winning trades. So this is why we need to protect our equity as well. So simply calculate your equity and lot size as 0.1 lot size for $1,000. If you have $500 in your equity, you have to take 0.05. That is also maximum. If you want, you can reduce the lot size. That is up to you. But maximum lot size is that. If you want only $100 in your account, you have to take 0.01. If you have $2,000 in your account, you have to take 0.2. If you have $5,000 in your account, you have to take maximum lot size as 0.5. If you have $10,000 in your account, your maximum lot size is 1.0. I repeat, if you want, you can take small lot size, but don't go beyond this. Money management is very important in financial market trading. So please follow money management strictly. If you have any doubts, you can call me at 8331994455, or you can mail me at forexkeys@gmail.com. Thank you. Bye-bye.